Hello! Now, I was going to review these all separately, but then I realised they're all British beers, and they're all from fairly good breweries as well. There's some new one, but anyway, so they're all British brewers, they're all cans. And they're all new. Wild Beer Company, and they're fresh. Beautiful artwork. That is beautiful artwork. You got your all in one side there for us beer tickers. You've got like cool backs. It's almost like a wooded area. And you got all the information there, all the stuff that you need, ingredients and such. Then you've got, so your Wild Beer Company. Then you've got the Waen Brewery. Horrible artwork. Because, well, for us beer tickers anyway. Because it starts there. There was a kids show called Dangermousse, if I remember. I don't know if that's the way they worked with the bricks. But we've got a new Yorkshire brewery, Vocation, and their Life and Death. And finally, Dark Star, which this is really nice artwork. I do like the way they've done it. It's their APA, because they've incorporated the flag and American stuff and American font there. Very beautiful artwork. This was sent to me by Stephanie from Darkstar, so thank you. This was purchased at Beer Ritz in Edenley, here in Yorkshire. This was purchased in Beer Central in Sheffield. And where did I get this one from? I think I got this one from Beer Ritz as well. So the lowest of the ABVs is... So I'll start with that lowest and then work my way up. So... What's the ABV on? So, the Dark Star. I do love it when you get a can and you get crisp, chilled opening. Oh, it smells nice fresh. I actually had a can of this the other day at Little Leeds, another bottle shop here in Yorkshire. My brother wanted to try it because he's a big fan of Darkstar. And the APA is actually one of their original first beers. And I remember drinking it at beer festivals and such and pubs when I first got into real ale. Beautiful colour to it. Nice, slightly hazy. Golden colour. Off-white head. So this big boy weighs in at 4.7%, so it is a session beer. Ooh, nice and subtle, cornflakey, little bits of, it's not overly bitter, which this is good, but you get a slight bit of bitter pineapple. So this is the Vocation, a brand new brewery in Yorkshire. First time I ever got to try their beers was a little micro pub in Ebden Bridge, beautiful place if you get a chance. Caitlin's, I think it's called. It's a little more colour in the head. Let's see. That's a little bit more pungent. This is an IPA at 6.5%. Yeah, the only IPA out of the four. Yeah, it's very pungent. It's slightly oaty. Get a bit of lemon. Oats, lemon, and a bit of... Try to get rid of people little fruits back. Body's a little bit off, but it's nicely crisp and tasty beer. You don't get any ABV at all. It's a little more caramelly, but very nice beer. So this is the Waen Brewery, and they're Dangermousse. Big fan of the brewery. My brother managed to visit earlier this year. This, I do like parts of this can. I'll just say, the only bit I don't like is the long wrap round Dangermousse thing. But it's their first ever can, so, but yeah, you can see that it's actually, the date is actually embedded into the label, which I do really like. Because sometimes when they put it on the base, it just rubbed much weight. But yeah, the only part I don't like is the Dangermousse going around the side. This weighs in at 6%. I should have gone. It's a little bit more pungent. I did have a can of this yesterday. I was not a fan, I have to say. So I had that really chilled. And it really, really, really caramelly. But I left it out a little bit. Still a little bit caramelly. Orange. It's got a little bit of skunkiness to it. Body's a little bit more easy. It's a little bit more golden brown. Yeah, still a bit skunky. Sometimes you do get that kind of skunky aroma in cans, just let it breathe a little bit. It's coming out a little bit better now. Get a little bit of golden syrup. But yeah, I remember drinking it and I was telling Mr. Kevin Black and Rob that it was just a bit too heavy on the aroma. I'm guessing that from the skunkiness, but it's definitely golden syrup, by the way. Cheers. Yeah, it's tasting a little bit better, but it's still got a skunkiness to it. Yeah, golden syrup. Finally, wild beer. I think Rob's had these, but I'm not too sure. Yeah, out of the four, I have to say the best artwork is definitely Dark Star and Wild Beer. I think the Wild Beer just edges it out because it's eaten. Everything's part of it, but the Dark Star's very close second. A little bit more glow on that, definitely golden body and easy, off-whited. It's a little bit of skunkiness there, a little bit of pineapple. Yeah, pineapple. Cheers. Oh, the body's perfect on that. It starts out a little thin, which is where you want it to be at that ABV. Then gets builds up. Very nice taste of beer. Yeah, so out of probably the four, yeah, they're all good, but I think I'd have to say the wild beer is probably the best one out of the four. For mostly for the artwork and the body and taste. That AP is so drinkable. I think it didn't last long when we had it at the Little Leeds. Yeah, just the Waen Brewery is probably my least favourite out of the four, mainly because of the artwork and that skunkiness. But yeah, it's great to see British canned beer slowly come up, and the artwork's very creative, just looks like the Americans. Check out Beer Central, check out Little Leeds, check out Beer Ritz, and support British breweries. You take care.